Hey, Mel, good morning. It's Dean in Chicago. How are you doing?
Good morning, Dean. Good morning. Yeah, good. How are you?
I'm doing very
well. How's things
well
over there? Cold, I'll bet. Cold,
it is. Yeah. It is super cold right here right now. We're having our coldest day of the year right now. We are taping this, and it's going to play back tomorrow morning, just so you know if the references make sense to you. So we'll get it started here. Guys, thanks very much. And it's not often that you can get an Academy Award winner to get up at this hour of the day to join us. Mel, we're sorry to drag you out of bed at this hour.
No, that's okay, so long as I have my, you know.
You've got your liquid energy with you there. That's good.
Oh, my goodness, yeah.
Edge of Darkness really made me feel like I was visiting with an old friend. It seemed like very familiar territory for you, going after the bad guy, you know, relentlessly chasing after the bad guy. Did you also feel the same way?
Well, there's aspects of it that are, you know, in my sort of career kind of patterns, I guess. But I don't know. I felt it was quite different enough, you know, character-wise, and indeed just the whole approach on perhaps a familiar sort of Jacobean tragedy theme, you know, approached in a different kind of way. Old-fashioned in a sense, a thriller, you know, a mystery, a detective story. And, you know, but it had a pretty good emotional core, I thought. That's why I liked it.
Yeah, a little bit tougher to do some of the stunts than, you know, back in the day in the Mad Max and Lethal Weapon days.
Oh, that stuff always gets harder. But it was never easy, you know. It was, you don't bounce back as you used to. So it's advisable to book the chiropractor in advance. You know, when you know something's coming, get ready. You know,
I've had everybody that I know who's from you know, the Boston or area or Northeast ask, what's Mel's accent like? You know, I'm from Chicago. What do I know from all that? But seemed pretty believable to me.
Well, hey, I got away. I asked the detective Tommy Duffy from Boston, you know, what he thought. He said, yeah, I got away with it. So anyway, my mother was raised and grew up in Brooklyn. And it's not dissimilar. I mean, it's not the same, but it's not that far away. So, you know, I grew up here in that.
Mel, everybody has been asking why you took the 7 years off from starring roles. I mean, you're at the top of your game, and you don't exactly walk away from it, but, I mean, you could have easily continued to star after picture after picture after picture.
You know, I kind of quietly backed away. Because, you know, if you do something for, I suppose it was getting on to be like 30 years, you can get stale. I felt I had a few bad habits, and I just wanted to try and shake them, you know. Sometimes time will do that. Not always. But time does inform one's craft, I think, and replenishes creative juices if you just go off and do something a little more menial and humbling. So, you know, coming back in, it's nice. You feel a little fresher, and hopefully maturation has done its job in another way.
Do you feel like you're a different person, maybe a better person than you were 5 years ago, 4 years ago? I mean, everything that we've read about, you've gone through a lot of ups and downs in the past few years.
Oh, yeah. 4 or 5 years, yeah. It's been, hey, it's a real roller coaster ride. You know, I think I'm the same person I always was, except for people as they go. Time teaches, and, you know, you learn as you go, so, hey.
Do you think that the public will perceive you any differently after all that's been in the news about you?
What are you referring to specifically?
Referring to the you know, the drinking problems, referring to what's been called the anti-Semitic rant, referring
all those things.
You know what I'm talking about.
That's almost 4 years ago, dude. I mean, I've moved on. I guess you haven't.
Well, I'm just wondering if you think that the public has moved on and will perceive you in the same light.
Well, I certainly hope so. You know, it is a while back, and you know, I've done all the necessary mea culpas. So, let's move on, dude. Come on.
Edge of Darkness opens today. It's good to see you back in the saddle and doing what you do best. Thanks a lot for joining us, Mel. Take care.
Bye bye. Asshole.